Over the entrepreneur's blueprint to massive success. But before I get started, I want to give you just a little bit of my personal background. I've been married for 17 years to my sweetheart, Summer, and I have 6 beautiful children. And we've always been entrepreneurs. We've always believed in the power of residual income. True story, right out of high school, I went to college for one day, and I sat down in class and I just kept hearing this voice, you know what, go start your own business. And I did. After that first hour, I left school and I went and started my first business. It was a pressure washing company. Kind of a funny story, you know, my friends made fun of me because everybody went off to college and they said, what are you gonna do? Are you gonna clean concrete for the rest of your life? And you know, I laughed and I says, no, but I'm gonna hire you guys to clean concrete for me. And I put them through college and they put me into my first house. And the rest is history. We've been entrepreneurs ever since. We've built several traditional businesses. We've owned everything from health club chains to tanning salons, lead generation companies that have done quite well. And we've also been blessed in the network marketing industry to build to the number one position inside of 3 different companies. Now, I don't want to mislead you. It hasn't been all just success stories. There's been a lot of challenges, a lot of growth opportunities, I like to call them, that have allowed us to be able to continually develop, and we're still going through them today. You know, I believe that sometimes we go through these challenges in life to push us down a different path to exactly where we're supposed to be. And what I wanted to do with this webinar is I wanted to be able to identify what are the biggest barriers to success for most entrepreneurs. What's holding most people back? And what can we do to help you overcome those barriers to success? You know, it's interesting. I read a statistic the other day that almost 80% of the United States population wants to be an entrepreneur, yet only 7% are. Do you realize that that's a 10-to-1 ratio of people that want to be self-employed as opposed to those that actually are? I also read that as much as 80% of small businesses fail inside of the first 18 months. Think about that. That's 8 out of 10 small businesses. The statistic is even higher in the direct sales industry. So I'm obsessed with, I've been consumed with, what is it that keeps people from having the kind of success that they want to have, to being able to enjoy the entrepreneur life, to be able to declare their financial freedom day, to be able to do the things that you want to do as opposed to the things that you have to do. And I believe that many entrepreneurs come into the world of entrepreneurship because of the freedom, right? It's the freedom of being your own boss, setting your own schedule. That's what's attractive about being an entrepreneur. But I think that sometimes that same freedom is also what gets us into trouble, right? Ironically, because now we've got to be holding ourselves accountable. I mean, we don't have anybody telling us when we have to be at work and when it's time to go to lunch and ultimately, you know, to get work done in a systematic format. It's all on you. And I think that there's a lot of people that get lost in that shuffle. It's kind of like trying to build a skyscraper on a shaky foundation, right? Or an unstable foundation. And so eventually things fall. And so what we do here at Entrepreneur Life is and our goal is to provide that bridge between starting a business and winning in business. And if you haven't had a chance to do so yet, if you haven't signed up for our free coaching library, we strongly encourage you to do so. We have some outstanding content and excellent coaching videos that are available on demand for free. All you have to do is sign up for the coaching library. Go, the person that invited you here to the presentation, get with them and they'll help you get your free account so that you can start accessing all kinds of outstanding coaching from top business coaches or business experts that are out there today. The first thing that I want to talk about is belief and confidence. You know, I have worked with a lot of entrepreneurs over the years, and one of the biggest challenges that I see is that they struggle with that self-confidence, right? Why would someone believe in you if you don't believe in yourself? You know, it's natural sometimes to have those voices that are inside our head that, you know, the whispers of, is this really going to work? Or is this going to, you know, are you really going to be able to succeed in this environment? You have to learn how to get those under control, right? You have to learn how to master your self-talk. And so the first thing that I want to talk about today is I want to give you some tips on how to build your own self-confidence, because it's true, it's proven that confidence is the most attractive quality on the planet. You know, one of my favorite quotes is a quote that says they knew who he was when he walked into the room. Now, there's a big difference between confidence and arrogance. We're not talking about arrogance here. We're talking about believing in yourself, knowing who you are, knowing the value that you bring to the table personally, right? Because when you value yourself, when you value your time, other people will value it as well. And it all comes back to you are what you think you are. So grab a pen and paper. I'm going to give you some tips here on how to start building that self-confidence. First of all, number one is to look important. It helps you think important, right? Your appearance, it speaks to those that you are in contact with. So be sure that it says positive things about you. Never leave home without feeling certain that you look like the kind of person that you want to be. You know, one of the best advertisements ever appearing in print is the Dress Right, You Can't Afford Not To slogan, sponsored by the American Institute of Men's and Boys Wear. In one ad, a policeman speaks and says, "You can usually spot a wrong kid just by the way that he looks." Now, sure, it's unfair, but it's a fact. People today are judged by their appearance. And once they have, you know, they've started to develop that reputation, it's hard to lose that, right? It's hard to, you know, once you think about it, school for a moment, right? Youngsters, they start to get in trouble and teachers start, you know, they start to kind of have an opinion of you. You've got to think about those things, right? Could the way that he or she looks, the clothes that they wear, could that give someone the wrong impression? Are you making sure that you are dressed right for the occasion wherever you go? I want you to think about this for a moment. You know, I woke up this morning and I was tired. I was up late and I was preparing for our presentation here this evening. And I have to tell you, when I get up in the morning and I take the time to get ready and I shave and I put on a nice sport coat, and I don't always wear a sport coat, but I have to tell you, there's something about the look on the outside that controls that feeling on the inside. Have you ever, you know, you put on a nice suit and a tie, or ladies, you put on a really nice dress and you get made up and you put those you know, your favorite pair of shoes on. How does it make you feel? Right? You feel confident. It makes a difference. And that's exactly what I'm talking about here. And this advertisement that I'm referring to, you know, is in the magic of thinking big. It was referring to children, but it also can be applied to adults as well. What you have to understand is that it costs little to look neat. It doesn't cost a lot of money. Take that slogan and interpret it to say, dress right because it pays. Remember to look important because it makes you feel and it makes you think important. Using clothing as a tool to lift your spirits builds confidence. You know, I once read about a professor who would tell his students to dress up for their final exam. Think about that, getting dressed up for your final exam. Here's the thing, he said, get a new view, have your suit pressed, shine your shoes, and I want you to look sharp because it will help you think sharp. He knew his stuff. Your physical exterior, it affects your mental interior. Anyone who has ever served in the Army knows a soldier feels like a soldier when they're in uniform. And a woman feels more like going to a party when she's dressed up for a party. An executive feels like an executive when he's dressed like one, and so forth. Your appearance talks to you, but it also talks to others. You know, there was once a sale at a supermarket. They had on one table, they had 1 pound of grapes for 99 cents and the other for $2.99 for 2 pounds. But this time it was packaged in polyethylene bags. And when the store clerk was asked, what's the difference between the grapes? He replied, the only difference is the polyethylene. We sell about twice as many that way because they look better. The point is, the better that you're packaged, the more public acceptance that you will receive. You know, when I was younger and I got involved in network marketing, I was barely 30 years old. I hadn't had any success in the industry, and my target market was baby boomers, 35 to 55, married, kids and bills. The biggest challenge that I had was I hadn't had any success yet, so how was I to go and speak to you know, people my father's age and try to convince them that I could help them go from where they are to where it is that they want to go. One of the ways that I addressed that barrier was to look the part. You know, I acted as if. Now, I don't believe in faking it until you make it. I believe in faithing it until you make it. That's different. But I acted accordingly. You know, if I asked myself, if I were making $1 million today, $1 million a year, what would I look like? How would I dress? How would I walk? How would I talk? How would I feel? How would I interact with somebody? What would that confidence look like? How would I shake their hand? When I look them in the eye, you know, what would my posture be? And that is who I became. And it's funny because people have said to me, well, you know, Travis, that's easy because you've been successful now. You've made some money in your lifetime. So it's easy for you to act that way. You know, when I start doing that, when I start making money, I'll act the same way. The reality is, no, it's the other way around. You've got to start becoming that successful person. You've got to see it in your mind's eye. And as you start to act as if, people will start to respond and treat you accordingly. Number two, think that your work is important. There's a story of three bricklayers. It's a classic. When asked, what are you doing? The first bricklayer replied that he was laying brick. The second bricklayer said he was earning $9 per hour. And the third bricklayer said that he was building a cathedral. Now, the story doesn't tell us what happened years later, but let me ask you a question. If you were to finish the story, which do you think went on to have more success and happiness in life? Maybe he became a foreman, an architect. Who knows? But one thing recruiters look for when considering if a candidate is good for a client is how they feel about their current job. And I can promise you that bricklayer that was building a cathedral had a totally different view than anyone else, right? Why? Because if they feel their present job is important, odds are they will take pride in their next job. That's why recruiters look and ask those questions that they do about how you feel about your job. Take what you do, for example. Do you understand the value that you bring to others? You know, it's pretty obvious why some people stay at their level all their lives. Their thinking alone, it keeps them there. A person who thinks that his job or service offered is important receives mental signals on how to do his job or the presentation or whatever case might be much better. And a better job means more sales. It means more rank advancements, more promotions, you know, more leaders that you develop inside of your organization, more duplication, and ultimately more money, more prestige, more happiness, more freedom. We've all noticed, think about this, we've all noticed how quickly children pick up on their parents' attitudes, their habits, their fears, and preferences of their parents. Whether it be food preferences of their parents, whether it's mannerisms, whether it's religious, or even political views, or any other type of behavior. The child is a living reflection of how their parents think, for he learns through imitation. So do adults, so does your team, and those that follow you. People continue to imitate others throughout life. People do what they see, not what they're told, and they imitate their leaders and their mentors and supervisors and so forth. The point is this, the way we think towards our job, our business, the call, the event, also determines how our subordinates think towards their jobs. Let me get my screen up to date here. I just get talking, I get excited, and so there you go. You got look important, number one. Number two is think your work is important. Number three is give yourself a pep talk. Coca-Cola is always reselling you on their product, right? Think about it. Enjoy a Coke and have a smile. You have a friend in Coke. Share a Coke with the name on the can. In that same way, we have to do the same for ourselves. We have to wake up every day and we have to sell ourselves to us. You gotta wake up, you gotta get in front of that mirroring and you gotta say, good morning, beautiful. You know what? You're blessed. People would be lucky to have you as their realtor, to be lucky to have you as their sponsor in business, to be lucky to be able to work for you. I'm gonna have an amazing day today. You see, you're programming your mind and you're setting the right expectation. Expectation is the key. Nobody exceeds beyond their wildest imagination unless he or she begins with some wild expectations. The mind is the most powerful force on earth. We need to start thinking our way to the top. Are you guys hearing me? Are you feeling me here? You got to start thinking your way to success. We need to treat our mind like a garden. And some of you might even need to go pull out that weed whacker. We need to pull out the weeds. We need to start planting. We need to start nurturing. We need to start loving ourselves. And that's when the harvest will come in. What you think, you create. And what you feel, you attract. What you imagine, you become. Remember, it's not what you are that holds you back. It's what you think that you are not. The next is challenge your doubts. In many cases, doubt stems just from not knowing all the facts. Our mind begins to play tricks on us, and we begin to create a mental picture of all of the things that could go wrong. We say things like, what if this doesn't work out? What if I fail? The stress is a result of your brain kicking in to actually protect you, to keep you safe. The key is to challenge these thoughts by asking a different question. What if this was the best thing that could ever happen to me? Or what if I don't take this chance, make this call? What will happen then? And things stay exactly the way they are now. You see, it's all about perspective, right? Instead of, you know, convincing yourself that, you know, taking this risk could be, you know, detrimental to your, you know, your career or you know, people aren't going to respond to you or you're not going to have the kind of success that you want to have, start asking you, well, what if this leads to me being able to declare my financial freedom day, to be able to do the things that I want to do rather than the things that I have to do? What if this is the best decision that I ever made in my life? Number five is you've got to gain a better understanding, right? Often we resist what we don't know. So take time to learn more about whatever it is that's intimidating you. You know, when I first started entrepreneur life, I have to tell you, I was so intimidated, especially by our back office system, Infusionsoft. Some of you will understand this. It literally freaked me out, and I had zero confidence that I would ever be able to navigate through this back office. Now today, I'm in there almost every single day. And I still have a really awesome coach who often helps me, but I'm gaining more confidence every single day. You know, here's an interesting, there's a TED Talk out there. And in this talk, it talks about how much time that it takes to be good at something. I'm not talking about becoming an expert, but to be just good at anything. It could be prospecting, it could be following up, it could be giving presentations. How much time do you really think that it takes? It could be playing a guitar. It doesn't matter what it is. So this person, they did a lot of studies on this, and everybody always kind of falls back to the 10,000 hour rule, right? Oh, Malcolm Gladwell says that it takes 10,000 hours to really be good at anything. And that's actually not true. It does take 10,000 hours of deliberate intention and activities to be an expert at something. But the reality is to be good at something takes about 20 hours of deliberate intentional practice. 20 hours. Are you willing to give whatever it is that you're looking to improve on right now 20 hours? You know, if you don't like picking up the phone and prospecting, do you think that you could muster your way through 20 hours of practice? Do you not like contacting or following up with individuals? Do you not like presenting? Whatever the case might be, whatever it is that you want to learn, just by becoming more and more familiar with it, you're going to build your confidence, right? Number six is improve those skills, right? The only way to get better is to learn and to grow. With knowledge comes confidence. With confidence comes competence. With competence comes results, right? Take a course, hire a coach, right? Attend a seminar, read books, do everything that you can to improve your skills. Number seven is programming. Learn to detox your mind. Write down negative beliefs and replace them with I am statements, right? Instead of saying I'm not good enough, say I am good enough. I am successful, right? You need to not only do that, you need to detox your environment. Where are you hanging out? Who are you hanging out with? I promise you that you're not going to gain confidence by hanging out with unhappy people at the bar every night. You're just not. You need to guard your mind, and you need to avoid drama and negativity like it's the plague. Some of you have friends, people that are in your inner circle, even family, that try to pull you in. You know what I'm talking about, right? They try to pull you in to their garbage, to their drama. I'm just telling you right now, you've got to put up a wall and you've got to say, I am not going to allow that into my life. You've got to protect your happiness. Don't allow naysayers anywhere near you. Instead, feed your mind, read books, read inspirational articles, listen to podcasts, log into the eLife coaching library and watch those videos daily. Next thing that you can do is you can make a decision. So many of you have something that you just haven't truly decided yet. It's something that you've been thinking about. Maybe it's working out. Maybe it's starting a new business. And that lack of that indecision is keeping you from your best. So many people struggle from paralysis through analysis. There's nothing that creates worry or self-doubt more than failing to make an important decision, just putting it off and putting it off. You have to decide. You have to take a chance. You have to get moving. Now, the next thing that we're going to talk about, well, let me get through these here. So again, you've got your eight things here, improving your skills, programming, and making a decision. The next thing is, we're going to talk about fear for a moment. You know, if somebody came to me today and they said, Travis, I want you to coach me to success. Here's the process that I would take them through. I always start with mindset, right? If you don't have your mind right, you don't have anything. And that's an ongoing process. We're constantly working on personal philosophy, beliefs, right? You have to go back and reprogram, and that takes time. The next thing is exploring fear. Most people are living their fears. They're not living their dreams, right? They're so crippled and worried about everything. It can be debilitating at times. Fear feeds resistance, and it stops us from achieving dreams and from challenging the status quo. It keeps us from using our voices, from trying something new. What are they going to think about me? And you know what? It's doubtful that there are many business people who have gone through their career without experiencing fear, loss of market share, loss of revenue, or worse still, loss of forward momentum, right? Many questions, can I do this? How many times have you said, can I do this? Who would want to listen to me? Do I have the experience to do this? I'm not really that good at sales. Crazy thoughts and irrational fears. The truth is that fear, for many of us, it's present every single day. The question is how to turn that feeling of fear into a powerful tool. So what I want to do is I want to give you five key tips today to remove the fear and achieve the success that you want. But before I do that, I want to share a little story with you. You might not know this about me, but I had a terrible fear of speaking in public when I first got started in this industry. In fact, when I first got started in network marketing and we started to have a little bit of success, I got a call from my upline. And they asked if we would make a guest appearance and speak on the national conference call. It was on Wednesday mornings at that time. And they wanted me to just share my story for 1 to 2 minutes. So from Sunday night until Wednesday, I literally, every night when I went to go to bed, I just started playing over and over in my mind what I was going to say, and I would think about it, and I would consume about it, and I would worry and get myself sick, and I literally didn't sleep for 3 days. And I finally got on the call, and you know, even though I had rehearsed everything I was going to say, it didn't come out nearly the way I thought it would, but it was okay. I got through it. And then they invited me back to speak again on another call, and pretty soon I was invited to actually do the introductions on a call, and then I was invited to speak in Provo, Utah at the first opportunity to actually host the opportunity meeting. Again, I didn't sleep for a week. I was terrified. When finally everybody arrived, I stood there in fear, and somebody finally came up and said, "Do you think it's time to get started?" I says, "Yeah, let's do it." I had Summer, my wife, sit right in the front row and hold water because my mouth would get so dry that I couldn't even talk. I would get cotton mouth. And you know, that was only, gosh, maybe 8-9 years ago, maybe 10 years ago at the most. So my point is this: we all have fears, but as you face them and you just work through them, you face those fears, you start to move past them. And here I am today, sitting in a studio talking to all of you. It all starts with you. It all starts with you. The only judgment that matters is the one you have of yourself. So you have to decide what it is that you're going to do, what it is that you're going to stand for what your testament is to the world. What difference that you want to make today to influence the lives of others around you. And the reason that I say that is because when you have a sense of clarity and purpose for yourself and your life, when you're clear on your why, you can then begin the journey to achieve what you desire from your life, business, or profession, and enjoy longevity and your success because you're living your life on purpose. It all starts with you. Number two is you've got to trust your intuition. You've got to understand what makes up your value system, and you need to own it. You need to live it. You need to work it. If you don't start leading from within, taking control to acknowledge your own values and beliefs and the person that you are on the inside, you will never be capable of being the better person and the leader that you need to be on the outside. The system is unique to you, and it's your responsibility to take ownership. There are times when it will be challenging, or when you will give in to other values and you will look back and wish that you had trusted your intuition more. That intuition, that gut feeling, don't ever mistrust it. It's a key part of you, and you should learn that it is one of your best assets. The next thing is to be brave. Step out of your comfort zone. It creates a new perspective, right? It's when we grow the most. Yet, fear still gets in the way, and we get trapped, right? We get trapped. We get stuck in a status quo, a place of stagnation, and no growth at all. You need to be brave. You need to take a journey to the edge. This alone will strengthen you and give a massive boost to your self-confidence and your self-belief. Every time that I spoke, every opportunity meeting, every call, I got a little bit more confident. You know, I still get a little nervous when I go out on stage, but I've learned to take those nerves and that actually gets me energized. It allows me really to be vulnerable and just be real. I've learned to connect to that energy and just, you know, I don't have a problem walking out letting people know, man, I'm a little bit nervous today. You know why? It's because I know that everybody out there in the audience is probably or would feel the same way, and it allows me to develop that connection. So you just learn to harness the energy in different ways, but you got to step outside of your comfort zone. It empowers and it engages and it forces you to face your fear head on. Imagine the possibilities and use this to fuel your bravery as you discover new opportunities and unlock new pathways to success. Don't be afraid to stand in the spotlight. Stand in your own spotlight. Don't be afraid to be brilliant. Have the resilience to shine and follow your dreams of business and personal success. There's nothing wrong with making your own profile or your own brand, your own video, your own Facebook Live. Be as strong as you possibly can, because it is only when you are operating from that position of self-leadership, that self-confidence that we were talking about earlier, that you can truly give to others. Number five, chase progress over perfection. Most of us instinctively spend time and energy seeking the big goals and achievements. Those moments that are incredibly satisfying and equally at times, they're hard to come by. Focusing only on those bigger goals can lead to disappointment, it can lead to frustration. And while those big picture goals are important, we often lose sight of the incremental successes and achievements along the way. Take time to acknowledge and recognize the small wins every single day. You know, my colleague and the Vice President of Entrepreneur Life, Paul Schwein, just wrote an article about this. He posted it on our blog. If you haven't been there, definitely check out our blog. We've got some great content in there as well. It's elifeuniversityblog.com. We'll put the information in, here below so you can access it. But in his article, he talked about how while big goals are great, it's those little daily actions, being able to cross things off your list every single day, that ultimately lead to success, right? You'll never change your life until you change something that you do daily. That's John Maxwell. It's a great article. Number six is take action. Much of what we fear is the future. It is important to bring our overthinking mind continuously into the present, focusing on what needs to be done right now, and take action and get on with it. Action allows us to overcome fear and inertia, because by taking action, by doing it anyway, by being brave and going for it, we feel back in control. Number seven is embrace decision making. When you hold back from making decisions out of fear of failure, it really keeps you, it just keeps you stuck, right? It keeps you stuck. It keeps that fear inside of you. This means lackluster projects, an endemic inability to change the status quo, and a potential lack of future leaders around you. A large part of being brave is to risk failing. Make the tough calls and show those around you that this is okay. It is those people who are willing to challenge themselves who make themselves accountable for their own success and ultimately their own happiness, right? Who recognizes the need to reach a little bit further, a little bit higher, who ends up with the biggest satisfaction? Just be 5% braver than everybody else. Just 5%. It'll make all the difference. Dig deep. Share your unique talent, your leadership, your expertise. Create energy, and that energy will drive change for you and everybody around you. It is those who take the leap, who face their fears, who are able to create momentum in their success dreams. At the end of the day, what will it cost you if you don't at least try? Right? That's the most important question that you could ask yourself. Now let's shift gears and let's talk about how you can become a go-to online authority, right? Because, you know, one of the biggest barriers that I see people having in business is they don't know how to create a pull marketing strategy. They fall into this category of marketers, and it doesn't matter what business that you're in, that just want to put information out. You know, I want to post on my wall, hopefully somebody will see it. I go into this group and I post and I hope somebody will see what I'm putting out there. And the problem is that marketing has changed so much over the last few years. In fact, we just came out with a new course in Entrepreneur Life. It's called The New Era of Marketing. And the reason that we did that is because people are not marketing in the year that we live in. They're not. They're still marketing as if, you know, social media hasn't changed everything. And they want to just climb to the top of a mountain and shout out a message and hope that somebody happens to just come across the message at just the right time when they want to buy. It doesn't work that way anymore, you guys. So you have to learn how to become an authority. And the best place to do it is online. If your business isn't online today, then I would dare say that you probably aren't in business. And if you are, you're leaving so much money on the table because your clientele is online. That's where they are today. So you've got to go to your clientele and you've got to engage in conversation. And the best way to do that is through content marketing. The number one way to accomplish this goal is to go out and add value. That's the key, right? Invest, invest, invest in others. And what happens is people start to come to you because of who you are and the value that you bring to the table. Content writing is a form of online writing, which is closely linked to web marketing campaigns. This means that creating the writing, which appears on websites or it could be blogs or wherever the case might be, and it's designed to add value, but it's also designed to engage your customers, right? Engage them with your product, into looking more into what it is that you do or the product that you offer. Some of you might be saying, yeah, but I'm not a writer. And you know what? I get it. I used to feel the same way. But what I found was over time, the more that I started to write, the more addicting that it actually became. It's actually therapeutic. And like anything else, the more you do it, the better you get. You know, it's funny. I go back and I read some of the stuff I was first posting on Facebook 4 or 5 years ago, and it was terrible. Like, it was terrible. And I'm not the best at punctuation. Like, I have to have Summer read everything before it goes out. Because when I do it, you know, like, sometimes when I pause, I just automatically put a comment in there. I don't even follow the grammatical rules. I just think, hey, if I were saying it and I would pause right now, I put a comment in there. But who cares? You know what? Just start writing. Start expressing yourself. And you'll start to fall in love with the process. So how do you come up with content? Everybody always asks, well, you know, how do you come up with the ideas that you write about? First of all, the number one way is to read, read, and read. When I read, I always come up with new ideas for a new blog post. Reading, it's the spark that ignites the new ideas in our life. You know, you've heard the term that readers are leaders, and it's so true. You know, read biographies of successful people, and if you have ADD and you kind of struggle to pay attention, I do, then just read blogs or articles. Subscribe to your favorite blogs and the RSS newsfeed so that You don't even have to go out and seek those articles. When they post, they just automatically come directly to you. But reading, it allows you to, it takes your mind into places that you might not be, and it gets the creative juices flowing. The second way is to pay attention to what's happening around you. There's lessons in everything. I mean, everything. So share your learning experiences with others. Another one of my favorites is be vulnerable, right? Share the good and the bad. Don't just, talk about all the good things that are happening. Vulnerability is the bridge that builds true relationships, and it's how we truly relate and we connect with others. So share these learning lessons. I go about my day, and if I see something, I'll take note of it. And that leads to my next point. When I get an idea or there's a lesson, write it down, right? Get a success journal or keep a journal specifically for this. You never know when a great idea will hit you. How many times have you come up with a great idea and you said, I'm gonna remember that one for later, and you forget it? I mean, I've done this so many times. If it's worth remembering, it's definitely worth writing down, right? The next thing, and this is very important, especially when it comes to blog posts, is you need to learn how to nail your headline, right? When content shared on Twitter or Facebook or LinkedIn and even other platforms, there's a huge opportunity for it to get discovered by others. So how can you increase the likelihood that somebody's gonna click to your content when a shared link flows down a person's social stream? Well, what makes you click on a particular link that you see or that you share on social media? Chances are it's a great headline that catches your attention and it earns your click, right? Along with a good photograph. That means that no matter what the subject, a great headline will help that piece of content spread much further. So what makes a great headline? It's similar to writing a great subject line for email marketing, for those of you that have lists. Same concept. How do you get somebody's attention in an email so that they click on your email and open it? Think about the four U's for great subject lines and headlines. Number one, useful. Why is this blog post valuable, right? Number two, ultra specific. What can I expect to learn from this blog post? Number three, unique. Why is this blog post compelling and unique? And then add a little bit of urgency, right? That's the last one. Why should I read this right now? Be sure to incorporate all four of these qualities in every headline that you write, and people will be more prone to continue sharing your content across social media. I'm gonna give you another bonus one here real quickly. Go join some type of a Shutterstock, deposit photos, some type of get a membership where you can pay monthly. It's not gonna cost you a lot of money, so that you can have access to high quality photos. It's amazing to me how many photos are reshared out there on social media with somebody else's brand, somebody else's, logos. The quality is it's been shared so many times that it's distorted and it doesn't look good. Go get some quality pictures. Just that alone, when you post, will set you apart from everybody else. The next thing is you need to learn how to find your voice, right? You need to write in your own unique voice. Don't try to copy somebody else. Your content should have an individual style that is unique to your personality or your brand. And once you develop your own voice, you're not done. Writers never stop working on their writing skills. As a content writer, you need to continually hone your skills too. Style is your most prized possession as a writer, and it should continue to evolve over the lifetime of your career. There's a great quote by Ernest Hemingway. He says, "We are all apprentices in a craft where no one ever becomes a master." If you haven't found your voice yet, just keep practicing. It's gonna come. And typically, creative professionals, they go through three stages of development. They go through imitation first, imitation mastery is second, and finally, innovation. And you start out reading and studying the styles of the writers that you admire. And then you use what you learn to develop your own style. Just remember, the great content, it builds relationships. And relationships are built on trust. And trust is what drives revenue, right? That's the goal. Now, as we start to wrap things up here today, I promised you that I would share with you one thing that will absolutely ignite your business. Take your business to the next level. And that one thing is coaching, or excuse me, is serving your way to the top. And then we're going to get into business coaching for a moment. You know, I used to work on a coaching floor. And when I was on that coaching floor, we were marketing products that helped business owners go from where they are to where it is that they want to go. And we would address the biggest barriers to success. And this was, gosh, this was a long time ago. And in the process of working on this floor, I learned a valuable skill that has helped me to have the success that we've had in business today. And that is, I learned the concept of serving versus selling. So many people get confused. So many people, you know, I want you to think about this. When somebody tries to sell you something, what happens? Right? You naturally resist. Nobody likes to be closed. Everybody wants to buy, but nobody wants to be closed. And so many of you, I want you to really hear me. Many of you are out there selling and telling and trying to convince people to buy your service and buy your products. And when you do that, you lose posture. People, you're not valuing what it is that you truly bring to the table, which is you and your ability to be able to help other people. And so what I learned through this process was how to stop selling and create an environment where people started to let their guards down because it was more about them. And that's the first thing I want you to understand. It is not about you, okay? It's about the person on the other side of the table. That's what your presentation is really about. You know, so many people are so anxious to sit down and they'll ask 1 to 2 qualifying questions. How you been? What have you been up to lately? And then they want to go right into their pitch, right? You've got to resist the itch to pitch. Because when you do that, people are going to resist. Why? Because it's just common nature. We are designed to be skeptics. We resist. Even if something we want, if somebody's trying to sell it, just like going to a gym, right? You go to a gym and you sit down with a sales guy and they're pushing and pushing. You might want to get in shape, but just the mere fact that somebody's trying to close you puts you into a position where you are now resisting, right? It's not about you. It's about the person on the other side of the table, about their goals, about what it is that they want, where they're dissatisfied. So you have to understand that. It's not about your product. I know that some of you have some great products at your company that you offer or within your respective businesses, but it's not even about that. It's the solution that your product will provide, right? Again, it's about the person on the other side of the table. So you have to understand what your presentation is about first, if you really want to make that transition from selling to serving. You know, selling is a great skill. I don't have anything against salespeople. I think, you know, selling is an art form. And I think selling will take you very far in life. But I think that there's something that happens when you shift your mindset from selling to serving, from a leadership level that takes you to the next level, that allows you to become that legacy leader where you're now developing other leaders, right? And so again, it's about the person that you're talking to. And the way that you do this, the way that you shift from presenting is by asking questions, right? When I'm just going over information and I'm sharing about my company, about my products, about my opportunity, about the owners of the company, when the company started, blah, 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 blah. All I'm doing is I'm putting information out. You're selling, you're telling. But when you ask questions, you're listening. There's a big difference, right? You gotta learn to ask the right questions. You know, when I get on a phone call with somebody, I open every single call the exact same way. Some of you might have been on a phone call with me. You know exactly how I started. Hey, listen, I'm excited to be here with you today. My name's Travis. It's nice to meet you. Before we get started, and we can talk business down the road, tell me a little bit about you. Anything that you're comfortable sharing, you're sharing, your story. I just love to get to know people, and then I can do the same. We can get to know each other a little bit better. It's very common for me to have a 30-minute conversation before we even get into business. What does that do? It develops rapport, and it shows the person on the other side of the table that I genuinely care about them. And usually that conversation just leads me down a natural path. Tell me a little bit about what you do for a living. What is it that you like the best about what you do? What is it that you like least about what you do? Most people have something that's they don't like so much about their job. You know, if you had your ideal situation, what would that look like? How does that differ from what you're doing today? You know, these questions allow me to gather information and ultimately decide if I can truly help that person, if I can help them in an area where they're dissatisfied, or I can help them go from where it is that they want to go. I might have somebody say, well, you know, I'd love to be able to have a little bit more stability in life. You know, I'm a salesperson and my income relies on that next sale. And it's up and down and up and down and up and down. And my ideal situation would be to have a little bit more stability in life. Okay, great. So if I could show you a way to have a little bit more stability in your life and allow you to be able to have a little bit more peace of mind, is that something that you would be open to taking a look at? See, it's not about my presentation. It's about giving them that stability. It's about them. And that's what you have to learn. It's all about asking the right questions. It's all about listening. You've got to learn to stop talking. God gave you two ears and one mouth for a reason. So you've got to understand. And we have a course, An Entrepreneur Life, that's outstanding. Serving Your Way to the Top, fantastic course that teaches you all about how to do this. But this is probably one of the most important and critical things that people, they get the concept, but they struggle with. They struggle with, and this is where we spend a lot of time with our coaching clients. The next thing is you gotta be a professional problem solver. That's what you're doing. At the end of the day, you are solving problems. You have to get to someone's source of pain and understand. Everybody has one, I'm telling you. If you have somebody who makes a lot of money, they might not have a lot of time. They might not have great health. You know, I'm telling you that everybody has a source of pain. You just have to become a master at showing that you care, because when you show people that you care, they're going to open themselves up to you. And you do that by asking the right questions. And when you do that, what happens is you build value. You know, I have people come to me all the time saying, well, people, I just can't get people to look at my presentation. They say that they're not interested in businesses like this. They don't have time. If you're getting those type of objections, I want you to listen to me. That means you're not building enough value. You're not. You're not building enough value in what it is that you are bringing to the table. If you're making it about your opportunity, chances are you're getting those objections all the time. Because as you start to really get to know someone and understand that this person is in a position where they want to retire their spouse because they believe that that spouse should be in a position to be able to spend more time with their grandparents or their grandchildren at this age and not necessarily have to be working all the time, and that's their driving force. And you start to speak to that and start talking about helping them to retire their spouse, you're building the value. And they're going to connect the dots and say, yeah, I'll take a look at what it is that you're working on, because they now have connected the dots to retiring that spouse or creating a retirement plan for themselves because that's quickly approaching, or creating enough income for that kid that's going to college, or getting out of that miserable, blood-sucking job that they hate, whatever it is. But you have to figure out how to attach to that. That's how you build value. And when the value is there, people will follow through. So again, serving your way to the top, one of the most important things that you can do. All right, now let's get into it. I jumped ahead a little bit earlier. So what's the number one way that you can explode your business? I'm just gonna tell you that the breakthroughs that I've had, I'm talking about big, major breakthroughs where I've pushed through the ceiling, gone from, you know, this income to this income to this income up here, was with coaching. It's with coaching. Think about it. Michael Jordan, one of the best basketball players of all time. Did he have a coach? Of course he did. Somebody that was there every day to push him, to provide feedback, to provide accountability, right? That's what coaches do. And somewhere along the way of life, we tend to, you know, start to just settle, and it's easier to not have a coach. Why? Because we don't have to be, we're accountable to ourselves. But that is the very reason why 80%+ of small businesses fail. Coaching is what changes everything. It's where business breakthroughs happen. Accountability is so essential for you, for me, for all of us. If we want to go to the next level, it is essential. Coaches provide feedback. They give you new ideas. They allow you to stand on the shoulders of giants, people that have been there before you. You know, it allows you to avoid the pitfalls and the trial and errors that most people go through in life. What's that worth to you? If you could shave off a couple, 2-3 years of learning curves, right? What's that worth to you? If you could get to that goal, that big goal that you have, so much faster, what is that worth to you? It's everything. It's everything. Coaching allows you to accomplish goals more quickly. It allows you to be able to make more money in your career, your profession, in your business. It is an absolute investment in you. At the end of the day, I don't care what company, what business that you are in, you're selling you. It's all about you. It's about the value that you bring to the table. And as you start to raise your leadership level, let's say on a scale of 1 to 10, you know, let's just pick a number. Let's say it's a 4. That's where you're at right now, 4. And I'm not saying you personally, I'm just saying hypothetically speaking. If you start to raise that to a 5 and a 6 and a 7, you start to attract better people in your life. You start to attract bigger opportunities into your life. You start to see things differently. You start to raise the lid on what you believe is possible, the expectations that you have for yourself. You know, I have huge expectations. You know, if I shared my goals with friends that don't play at that same level, they might think that I'm crazy. In fact, I have family members that think that I'm unrealistic. Great, because I want to be unrealistic. Because that expectation is what's allowed me to be able to have the success that I want to have. And so it's so critical that you align yourself with somebody who has that big vision, who has accomplished what it is that you want in life. And that's so important. You know, on social media today, everybody's marketing something. I see this all the time, right? And I see posts about it. Everybody's a teacher or a coach today. You know what? Number one, I think that there's a big need for coaches. But let's be clear. People who have accomplished the kind of success that you want to have. A lot of people want to just take that shortcut and go right into coaching without ever doing. So if you're looking for a coach or if you're aligning with someone, find someone who has had the kind of success that you want to have in life. And more importantly, they have the kind of values that you want to have, right? Do they have a happy marriage? Someone can be successful in business, but you know, they don't have a happy marriage. They're never at home with their family. So ask yourself, what are my values? What's important to me? And does this person have the kind of success that I want to have in life? But at the end of the day, you guys, coaching is what's going to allow you to go from here to here and do it so much faster. What is that worth to you? Now, we've put together a very special promotion that I want to share with you today. And this offer is... it's going to be good literally for 24 hours. That's it. So from the time that this webinar ends tonight through tomorrow, this special promotion will be up. And we did this because we wanted to create a coaching program that would help small business owners literally ignite their business and really create that momentum going into 2017. So we created a 5-week coaching program. It's a virtual coaching program, which means that you get to log into our university. You can access these courses on demand. Each new course will open up every Monday for you. You log in, you literally take the courses. When you're done, you take a quiz, you get certified. But the information in these courses is essential. It's, in fact, if someone came to me today and said, Travis, I want you to coach me to be successful in business, this is where we would start. And these are the first 5 sessions that you and I would do together. So I've taken these courses, I actually wrote curriculum, we filmed them in studio, some of the highest engaging quality content that's available online from a coaching standpoint. Let me go through what these are. The first one is a course that I love. It's called Cultivating the Mindset of an Entrepreneur, right? If you don't have your mind right, you don't have anything. You've got to get your head right. And so we put a course together. It's an over an hour long that teaches you about mindset and the strategies that top producers use to get their head right, their belief systems, their values, those type of things, so that you've got your thinking right, right? Your thinking is everything. You've got to think your way to success. We said it earlier. It's a $197 course, and we are offering it at a significant discount today, but not just that course. We've also put together another course that I absolutely love. It's called Facing Your Giants. Most people are living their fears, right? They're not living their dreams. But how do you really move past those fears? Fear of failure, fear of rejection, fear of even success, right? Those are all fear of what people think of me. We give you a bulletproof strategy of how to move past those fears so that you can start living the entrepreneur life that you deserve. Another course that's in this particular coaching program is Connecting to Thrive in Business. You know, I put this course together because, you know, I asked myself, what's one of the most important skills that you've learned that has allowed you and Summer to be successful in business? And really, It's building relationships, right? It's connecting at the heart level. And learning how to nurture those relationships, it's all about connecting to thrive in business. So we put a course together that teaches you how to grow your network on purpose, to develop relationships. What is it at the core level that allows you to build relationships of trust and ultimately be able to expand that network? Somebody once said that you can never have enough relationships. They're like money in the bank, right? You can never have enough of them. So we're going to teach you how to go out to connect to thrive in business. Course number four is so critical. It's all about branding, right? People are so confused about branding today. They think that marketing and branding are one and the same, and they're not. They're two totally different things. It's like the sun and the moon. And branding has changed so much, again, with social media. So what we've done is we have taken the principles that we've used to build million-dollar businesses online, and we're sharing those secrets in this course. It's called Unlocking the Secrets of Building a Million-Dollar Brand. Summer and I have been very, very specific about how we've built our brand online. That's allowed us to sponsor hundreds of people online and build to the number one position inside of three different companies. We built our businesses primarily online. So we're going to teach you exactly how we did that. The most effective strategies to build a brand, both online and offline, and on a shoestring budget as well. And finally, this course is so critical today. It's called The New Era of Marketing. And this course is going to teach you the most effective marketing strategies today from a return on investment standpoint, and more importantly, how to go out and market your business and get the kind of results that you're looking for that lead to an increase in sales. So again, we've put together this Ignite program, this coaching program. The value on this program is almost $1,000, and tonight we're offering it to you for $274. In fact, you can sign up right here and right below me. There's an add to cart button. If you click on that cart, you'll be able to take advantage of this offer. Again, 24 hours. The clock starts right now. You can take advantage of this special offer. What you can expect is from the time that you sign up, you'll get an email from my team that tells you how to log into the university. You'll get access immediately to our first coaching session, and you and I will be spending 5 weeks together here where we're going to be going through and teaching you these principles of how to be successful in business. So with that, once again, I want to say thank you to those of you that are plugging in to the Entrepreneur Life, you know, this community that we are building. Make sure that you're part of our Entrepreneur Life community. We have an outstanding affiliate program for those of you that are looking to create more leads in your business and create an additional revenue stream without having a conflicting business. Maybe you're in network marketing and you don't want to build conflicting businesses. This is the perfect complementary business for you. We definitely encourage you to go over to myelifepro.com and check out the benefits of becoming an affiliate. And lastly, stay plugged into what we're doing. We've got some great information we're going to continually be releasing, excellent trainings that we're releasing each week into the new free coaching library. And I'll tell you, we've got some outstanding coaching programs that are available. So we definitely encourage you to plug in, take advantage of this outstanding eIgnite program that we've put together for you. And with that, thank you guys so much for tuning in. We'll look forward to connecting with you again soon. Take care. Hello and welcome, everybody. I'm excited to be here with you. This is Travis Flaherty, and we have got a big presentation ahead of us tonight. We are going to be going over the Entrepreneur's Blueprint to Massive Success. But before I get started, I want to give you just a little bit of my personal background. I've been married for 17 years to my sweetheart, Summer, and I have 6 beautiful children. And we've always been entrepreneurs. We've always believed in the power of residual income. True story. Right out of high school, I went to college for one day, and I sat down in class, and I just kept hearing this voice, you know what, go start your own business. And I did. After that first hour, I left school, and I went and started my first business. It was a pressure washing company. Kind of a funny story, you know, my friends made fun of me because everybody went off to college, and they said, what are you going to do? Are you going to clean concrete for the rest of your life? And you know, I laughed and I says, no, but I'm going to hire you guys to clean concrete for me. And I put them through college and they put me into my first house. And the rest is history. We've been entrepreneurs ever since. We've built several traditional businesses. We've owned everything from health club chains to tanning salons, lead generation companies that have done quite well. And we've also been blessed in the network marketing industry to build to the number one position inside of three different companies. Now, I don't want to mislead you. It hasn't been all just success stories. There's been a lot of challenges, a lot of growth opportunities, I like to call them, that have allowed us to be able to continually develop, and we're still going through them today. You know, I believe that sometimes we go through these challenges in life to push us down a different path to exactly where we're supposed to be. And what I wanted to do with this webinar is I wanted to be able to identify what are the biggest barriers to success for most entrepreneurs. What's holding most people back, and what can we do to help you overcome those barriers to success? You know, it's interesting. I read a statistic the other day that almost 80% of the United States population wants to be an entrepreneur, yet only 7% are. Do you realize that that's a 10-to-1 ratio of people that want to be self-employed as opposed to those that actually are? I also read that as much as 80% of small businesses fail inside of the first 18 months. Think about that. That's 8 out of 10 small businesses. The statistic is even higher in the direct sales industry. So I'm obsessed with, I've been consumed with, what is it that keeps people from having the kind of success that they want to have, to being able to enjoy the entrepreneur life, to be able to declare their financial freedom day, to be able to do the things that you want to do as opposed to the things that you have to do. And I believe that many entrepreneurs come into the world of entrepreneurship because of the freedom, right? It's the freedom of being your own boss, setting your own schedule. That's what's attractive about being an entrepreneur. But I think that sometimes that same freedom is also what gets us into trouble, right? Ironically, because now we've got to be holding ourselves accountable. I mean, we don't have anybody telling us when we have to be at work and when it's time to go to lunch and ultimately, you know, to get work done in a systematic format. It's all on you. And I think that there's a lot of people that get lost in that shuffle. It's kind of like trying to build a skyscraper on a shaky foundation, right? Or an unstable foundation. And so eventually things fall. And so what we do here at Entrepreneur Life is and our goal is to provide that bridge between starting a business and winning in business. And if you haven't had a chance to do so yet, if you haven't signed up for our free coaching library, we strongly encourage you to do so. We have some outstanding content and excellent coaching videos that are available on demand for free. All you have to do is sign up for the coaching library. Go, the person that invited you here to the presentation, get with them, and they'll help you get your free account so that you can start accessing all kinds of outstanding coaching from top business coaches or business experts that are out there today. The first thing that I want to talk about is belief and confidence. You know, I have worked with a lot of entrepreneurs over the years, and one of the biggest challenges that I see is that they struggle with that self-confidence, right? Why would someone believe in you if you don't believe in yourself? You know, it's natural sometimes to have those voices that are inside our head that, you know, they, you know, the whispers of, is this really going to work? Or is this going to, you know, are you really going to be able to succeed in this environment? You have to learn how to get those under control, right? You have to learn how to master your self-talk. And so the first thing that I want to talk about today is I want to give you some tips on how to build your own self-confidence, because it's true, it's proven that confidence is the most attractive quality on the planet. You know, one of my favorite quotes is a quote that says they knew who he was when he walked into the room. Now, there's a big difference between confidence and arrogance. We're not talking about arrogance here. We're talking about believing in yourself, knowing who you are, knowing the value that you bring to the table personally, right? Because when you value yourself, when you value your time, other people will value it as well. And it all comes back to you are what you think you are. So grab a pen and paper. I'm going to give you some tips here on how to start building that self-confidence. First of all, number one is to look important. It helps you think important, right? Your appearance, it talks, it speaks to those that you are in contact with. So be sure that it says positive things about you. Never leave home without feeling certain that you look like the kind of person that you want to be. You know, one of the best advertisements ever appearing in print is the Dress Right, You Can't Afford Not To slogan, sponsored by the American Institute of Men's and Boys Wear. In one ad, a policeman speaks and says, "You can usually spot a wrong kid just by the way that he looks." Now, sure, it's unfair, but it's a fact. People today are judged by their appearance. And once they have, you know, they've started to develop that reputation, it's hard to lose that, right? It's hard to, you know, once you think about it, school for a moment, right? Youngsters, they start to get in trouble and teachers start, you know, they start to kind of have an opinion of you. You've got to think about those things, right? Could the way that he or she looks, the clothes that they wear, could that give someone the wrong impression? Are you making sure that you are dressed right for the occasion wherever you go? I want you to think about this for a moment. You know, I woke up this morning and I was tired. I was up late and I was preparing for our presentation here this evening. And I have to tell you, when I get up in the morning and I take the time to get ready and I shave and I put on a nice sport coat, and I don't always wear a sport coat, but I have to tell you, there's something about the look on the outside that controls that feeling on the inside. Have you ever, you know, you put on a nice suit and a tie, or ladies, you put on a really nice dress and you get made up and you put those you know, the favorite pair of shoes on. How does it make you feel? Right? You feel confident. It makes a difference. And that's exactly what I'm talking about here. And this advertisement that I'm referring to, you know, is in the magic of thinking big, it was referring to children, but it also can be applied to adults as well. What you have to understand is that it costs little to look neat. It doesn't cost a lot of money. Take that slogan and interpret it to say, dress right because it pays. Remember to look important because it makes you feel and it makes you think important. Using clothing as a tool to lift your spirits builds confidence. You know, I once read about a professor who would tell his students to dress up for their final exam. Think about that, getting dressed up for your final exam. Here's the thing, he said, get a new view, have your suit pressed, shine your shoes, and I want you to look sharp because it will help you think sharp. He knew his stuff. Your physical exterior, it affects your mental interior. Anyone who has ever served in the Army knows a soldier feels like a soldier when they're in uniform. And a woman feels more like going to a party when she's dressed up for a party. An executive feels like an executive when he's dressed like one, and so forth. Your appearance talks to you, but it also talks to others. You know, there was once a sale at a supermarket. They had on one table, they had 1 pound of grapes for 99 cents and the other for $2.99 for 2 pounds. But this time it was packaged in polyethylene bags. And when the store clerk was asked, what's the difference between the grapes? He replied, the only difference is the polyethylene. We sell about twice as many that way because they look better. The point is, the better that you're packaged, the more public acceptance that you will receive. You know, when I was younger and I got involved in network marketing, I was barely 30 years old. I hadn't had any success in the industry, and my target market was baby boomers, 35 to 55, married, kids and bills. The biggest challenge that I had was I hadn't had any success yet. So how was I to go and speak to, you know, people my father's age and try to convince them that I could help them go from where they are to where it is that they want to go? One of the ways that I addressed that barrier was to look the part. You know, I acted as if. Now, I don't believe in faking it until you make it. I believe in faithing it until you make it. That's different. But I acted accordingly. You know, if I were making $1 million today, $1 million a year, what would I look like? How would I dress? How would I walk? How would I talk? How would I feel? How would I interact with somebody? What would that confidence look like? How would I shake their hand? When I look them in the eye, you know, what would my posture be? And that is who I became. And it's funny because people have said to me, well, you know, Travis, that's easy because you've been successful now. You've made some money in your lifetime. So it's easy for you to act that way. You know, when I start doing that, when I start making money, I'll act the same way. The reality is, no, it's the other way around. You've got to start becoming that successful person. You've got to see it in your mind's eye. And as you start to act as if, people will start to respond and treat you accordingly. Number two, think that your work is important. There's a story of three bricklayers. It's a classic. When asked, "What are you doing?" the first bricklayer replied that he was laying brick. The second bricklayer said he was earning $9 per hour. And the third bricklayer said that he was building a cathedral. Now, the story doesn't tell us what happened years later, but let me ask you a question. If you were to finish the story, which do you think went on to have more success and happiness in life? Maybe he became a foreman, an architect. Who knows? But one thing recruiters look for when considering if a candidate is good for a client is how they feel about their current job. And I can promise you that bricklayer that was building a cathedral had a totally different view than anyone else, right? Why? Because if they feel their present job is important, odds are they will take pride in their next job. That's why recruiters look and ask those questions that they do about how you feel about your job. Take what you do, for example. Do you understand the value that you bring to others? You know, it's pretty obvious why some people stay at their level all their lives. Their thinking alone, it keeps them there. A person who thinks that his job or service offered is important receives mental signals on how to do his job or the presentation or whatever case might be much better. And a better job means more sales. It means more rank advancements, more promotions, you know, more leaders that you develop inside of your organization, more duplication, and ultimately more money, more prestige, more happiness, more freedom. We've all noticed, think about this, we've all noticed how quickly children pick up on their parents' attitudes, their habits, their fears, and preferences of their parents. Whether it be food preferences of their parents, whether it's mannerisms, whether it's religious or even political views or any other type of behavior, the child is a living reflection of how their parents think, for he learns through imitation. So do adults. So does your team and those that follow you. People continue to imitate others throughout life. People do what they see, not what they're told, and they imitate their leaders and their mentors and supervisors and so forth. The point is this, the way we think towards our job, our business, the call, the event, also determines how our subordinates think towards their jobs. Let me get my screen up to date here. I just get talking, I get excited. And so there you go, you got look important, number one. Number two is think your work is important. Number three is give yourself a pep talk. Coca-Cola is always reselling you on their product, right? Think about it. Enjoy a Coke and have a smile. You have a friend in Coke. Share a Coke with the name on the can. In that same way, we have to do the same for ourselves. We have to wake up every day and we have to sell ourselves to us. You gotta wake up, you gotta get in front of that mirror and you gotta say, "Good morning, beautiful. You know what? You're blessed." People would be lucky to have you as their realtor, to be lucky to have you as their sponsor in business, to be lucky to be able to work for you. "I'm gonna have an amazing day today." You see, you're programming your mind and you're setting the right expectation. Expectation is the key. Nobody exceeds beyond their wildest imagination unless he or she begins with some wild expectations. The mind is the most powerful force on earth. We need to start thinking our way to the top. Are you guys hearing me? Are you feeling me here? You got to start thinking your way to success. We need to treat our mind like a garden. And some of you might even need to go pull out that weed whacker. We need to pull out the weeds. We need to start planting. We need to start nurturing. We need to start loving ourselves. And that's when the harvest will come in. What you think, you create. And what you feel, you attract. What you imagine, you become. Remember, it's not what you are that holds you back. It's what you think that you are not. The next is challenge your doubts. In many cases, doubt stems just from not knowing all the facts. Our mind begins to play tricks on us, and we begin to create a mental picture of all of the things that could go wrong. We say things like, "Ah, man, what if this doesn't work out? What if I fail?" stress is a result of your brain kicking in to actually protect you, to keep you safe. The key is to challenge these thoughts by asking a different question. What if this was the best thing that could ever happen to me? Or what if I don't take this chance, make this call? What will happen then? And things stay exactly the way they are now. You see, it's all about perspective, right? Instead of, you know, convincing yourself that, you know, taking this risk could be, you know, detrimental to your, you know, your career or you know, people aren't going to respond to you or you're not going to have the kind of success that you want to have, start asking you, well, what if this leads to me being able to declare my financial freedom day, to be able to do the things that I want to do rather than the things that I have to do? What if this is the best decision that I ever made in my life? Number five is you've got to gain a better understanding, right? Often we resist what we don't know. So take time to learn more about whatever it is that's intimidating you. You know, when I first started entrepreneur life, I have to tell you, I was so intimidated, especially by our back office system Infusionsoft. Some of you will understand this. It literally freaked me out, and I had zero confidence that I would ever be able to navigate through this back office. Now today, I'm in there almost every single day. And I still have a really awesome coach who often helps me, but I'm gaining more confidence every single day. You know, here's an interesting, there's a TED Talk out there. And in this talk, it talks about how much time that it takes to be good at something. I'm not talking about becoming an expert, but to be just good at anything. It could be prospecting, it could be following up, it could be giving presentations. How much time do you really think that it takes? It could be playing a guitar. It doesn't matter what it is. So this person, they did a lot of studies on this, and everybody always kind of falls back to the 10,000 hour rule, right? Oh, Malcolm Gladwell said that it takes 10,000 hours to really be good at anything, and that's actually not true. It does take 10,000 hours of deliberate intention and activities to be an expert at something. But the reality is to be good at something takes about 20 hours of deliberate intentional practice. 20 hours. Are you willing to give whatever it is that you're looking to improve on right now, 20 hours? You know, if you don't like picking up the phone and prospecting, do you think that you could muster your way through 20 hours of practice? Do you not like contacting or following up with individuals? Do you not like presenting? Whatever the case might be, whatever it is that you want to learn, just by becoming more and more familiar with it, you're going to build your confidence, right? Number six is improve those skills, right? The only way to get better is to learn and to grow. With knowledge comes confidence. With confidence comes competence. With competence comes results, right? Take a course, hire a coach, right? Attend a seminar, read books, do everything that you can to improve your skills. Number seven is programming. Learn to detox your mind. Write down negative beliefs and replace them with I am statements, right? Instead of saying I'm not good enough, say I am good enough. I am successful, right? You need to not only do that, you need to detox your environment. Where are you hanging out? Who are you hanging out with? I promise you that you're not going to gain confidence by hanging out with unhappy people at the bar every night. You're just not. You need to guard your mind, and you need to avoid drama and negativity like it's the plague. Some of you have friends, people that are in your inner circle, even family, that try to pull you in. You know what I'm talking about, right? They try to pull you in to their garbage, to their drama. I'm just telling you right now, you've got to put up a wall, and you've got to say, I am not going to allow that into my life. You've got to protect your happiness. Don't allow naysayers anywhere near you. Instead, feed your mind. Read books. Read inspirational articles. Listen to podcasts. Log into the eLife coaching library and watch those videos daily. Next thing that you can do is you can make a decision. So many of you have something that you just haven't truly decided yet. It's something that you've been thinking about. Maybe it's working out. Maybe it's starting a new business. And that lack of that indecision is keeping you from your best. So many people struggle from paralysis through analysis. There's nothing that creates worry or self-doubt more than failing to make an important decision, just putting it off and putting it off. You have to decide. You have to take a chance. You have to get moving. Now, the next thing that we're going to talk about, well, let me get through these here. So again, you've got your eight things here, improving your skills, programming, and making a decision. The next thing is, we're going to talk about fear for a moment. You know, if somebody came to me today and they said, Travis, I want you to coach me to success. Here's the process that I would take them through. I always start with mindset, right? If you don't have your mind right, you don't have anything. And that's an ongoing process. We're constantly working on personal philosophy, beliefs, right? You have to go back and reprogram, and that takes time. The next thing is exploring fear. Most people are living their fears, they're not living their dreams, right? They're so crippled and worried about everything. Can be debilitating at times. Fear feeds resistance, and it stops us from achieving dreams and from challenging the status quo. It keeps us from using our voices, from trying something new. What are they going to think about me? And you know what? It's doubtful that there are many business people who have gone through their career without experiencing fear, loss of market share, loss of revenue, or worse still, loss of forward momentum, right? Many questions, can I do this? How many times have you said, can I do this? Who would want to listen to me? Do I have the experience to do this? I'm not really that good at sales. Crazy thoughts and irrational fears. The truth is that fear, for many of us, it's present every single day. The question is how to turn that feeling of fear into a powerful tool. So what I want to do is I want to give you 5 key tips today to remove the fear and achieve the success that you want. But before I do that, I want to share a little story with you. You might not know this about me, but I had a terrible fear of speaking in public when I first got started in this industry. In fact, when I first got started in network marketing and we started to have a little bit of success, I got a call from my upline and they asked if we would make a guest appearance and speak on the national conference call. It was on Wednesday mornings at that time. And they wanted me to just share my story for 1 to 2 minutes. So from Sunday night until Wednesday, I literally, every night when I went to go to bed, I just started playing over and over in my mind what I was gonna say, and I would think about it and I would consume about it. And I would worry and get myself sick, and I literally didn't sleep for 3 days. And I finally got on the call, and you know, even though I had rehearsed everything I was going to say, it didn't come out nearly the way I thought it would. But it was okay. I got through it. And then they invited me back to speak again on another call. And pretty soon I was invited to actually do the introductions on a call. And then I was invited to speak in Provo, Utah at the first opportunity to actually host the opportunity meeting. Again, I didn't sleep for a week. I was terrified. When finally everybody arrived, I stood there in fear, and somebody finally came up and said, "Do you think it's time to get started?" I says, "Yeah, let's do it." I had Summer, my wife, sit right in the front row and hold water because my mouth would get so dry that I couldn't even talk. I would get cotton mouth. And you know, that was only, gosh, maybe 8, 9 years ago, maybe 10 years ago at the most. So my point is this: we all have fears, but as you face them and you just work through them, you face those fears, you start to move past them. And here I am today, sitting in a studio talking to all of you. It all starts with you. It all starts with you. The only judgment that matters is the one you have of yourself. So you have to decide what it is that you're going to do, what it is that you're going to stand for, what your testament is to the world, what difference that you want to make today to influence the lives of others around you. And the reason that I say that is because when you have a sense of clarity and purpose for yourself and your life, when you're clear on your why, you can then begin the journey to achieve what you desire from your life, business, or profession, and enjoy longevity and your success because you're living your life on purpose. It all starts with you. Number 2 is you've got to trust your intuition. You've got to understand what makes up your value system, and you need to own it. You need to live it. You need to work it. If you don't start leading from within, taking control to acknowledge your own values and beliefs and the person that you are on the inside, you will never be capable of being the better person and the leader that you need to be on the outside. The system is unique to you, and it's your responsibility to take ownership. There are times when it will be challenging, or when you will give in to other values and you will look back and wish that you had trusted your intuition more. That intuition, that gut feeling, don't ever mistrust it. It's a key part of you, and you should learn that it is one of your best assets. The next thing is to be brave. Step out of your comfort zone. It creates a new perspective, right? It's when we grow the most. Yet, fear still gets in the way and we get trapped, right? We get trapped, we get stuck in a status quo, a place of stagnation and no growth at all. You need to be brave. You need to take a journey to the edge. This alone will strengthen you and give a massive boost to your self-confidence and your self-belief. Every time that I spoke, every opportunity meeting, every call, I got a little bit more confident. You know, I still get a little nervous when I go out on stage, but I've learned to take those nerves and that actually gets me energized. It allows me really to be vulnerable and just be real. I've learned to connect to that energy and just, you know, I don't have a problem walking out and letting people know, man, I'm a little bit nervous today. You know why? It's because I know that everybody out there in the audience is probably or would feel the same way, and it allows me to develop that connection. So you just learn to harness the energy in different ways, but you gotta step outside of your comfort zone. Empowers and engages, and it forces you to face your fear head on. Imagine the possibilities and use this to fuel your bravery as you discover new opportunities and unlock new pathways to success. Don't be afraid to stand in the spotlight. Stand in your own spotlight. Don't be afraid to be brilliant. Have the resilience to shine and follow your dreams of business and personal success. There's nothing wrong with making your own profile or your own brand, your own video, your own Facebook Live. Be as strong as you possibly can, because it is only when you are operating from that position of self-leadership, that self-confidence that we were talking about earlier, that you can truly give to others. Number five, chase progress over perfection. Most of us instinctively spend time and energy seeking the big goals and achievements. Those moments that are incredibly satisfying and equally at times, they're hard to come by. Focusing only on those bigger goals can lead to disappointment. It can lead to frustration. And while those big picture goals are important, we often lose sight of the incremental successes and achievements along the way. Take time to acknowledge and recognize the small wins every single day. You know, my colleague and the Vice President of Entrepreneur Life, Paul Schween, just wrote an article about this. He posted it on our blog. If you haven't been there, definitely check out our blog. We've got some great content in there as well. It's elifeuniversityblog.com. We'll put the information in, here below so you can access it. But in his article, he talked about how while big goals are great, it's those little daily actions, being able to cross things off your list every single day that ultimately lead to success, right? You'll never change your life until you change something that you do daily. That's John Maxwell. It's a great article. Number six is take action. Much of what we fear is the future. It is important to bring our overthinking mind continuously into the present, focusing on what needs to be done right now and take action and get on with it. Action allows us to overcome fear and inertia, because by taking action, by doing it anyway, by being brave and going for it, we feel back in control. Number seven is embrace decision making. When you hold back from making decisions out of fear of failure, it really keeps you, it just keeps you stuck, right? It keeps you stuck. It keeps that fear inside of you. This means lackluster projects and an endemic inability to change the status quo and a potential lack of future leaders around you. A large part of being brave is to risk failing. Make the tough calls and show those around you that this is okay. It is those people who are willing to challenge themselves who make themselves accountable for their own success and ultimately their own happiness, right? Who recognizes the need to reach a little bit further, a little bit higher? Who ends up with the biggest satisfaction? Just be 5% braver than everybody else. Just 5%. It'll make all the difference. Dig deep. Share your unique talent, your leadership, your expertise. Create energy And that energy will drive change for you and everybody around you. It is those who take the leap, who face their fears, who are able to create momentum in their success dreams. At the end of the day, what will it cost you if you don't at least try? Right? That's the most important question that you could ask yourself. Now let's shift gears and let's talk about how you can become a go-to online authority, right? Because, you know, one of the biggest barriers that I see people having in business is they don't know how to create a pull marketing strategy. They fall into this category of marketers, and it doesn't matter what business that you're in, that just want to put information out. You know, I want to post on my wall, hopefully somebody will see it. I go into this group and I post and I hope somebody will see what I'm putting out there. And the problem is that marketing has changed so much over the last few years. In fact, we just came out with a new course in Entrepreneur Life. It's called The New Era of Marketing. And the reason that we did that is because people are not marketing in the year that we live in. They're not. They're still marketing as if, you know, social media hasn't changed everything. And they want to just climb to the top of a mountain and shout out a message and hope that somebody happens to just come across the message at just the right time when they want to buy. It doesn't work that way anymore, you guys. So you have to learn how to become an authority. And the best place to do it is online. If your business isn't online today, then I would dare say that you probably aren't in business. And if you are, you're leaving so much money on the table because your clientele is online. That's where they are today. So you've got to go to your clientele and you've got to engage in conversation. And the best way to do that is through content marketing. The number one way to accomplish this goal is to go out and add value. That's the key, right? Invest, invest, invest in others. And what happens is people start to come to you because of who you are and the value that you bring to the table. Content writing is a form of online writing, which is closely linked to web marketing campaigns. This means that creating the writing, which appears on websites or it could be blogs or wherever the case might be, and it's designed to add value, but it's also designed to engage your customers, right? Engage them with your product into looking more into what it is that you do or the product that you offer. Some of you might be saying, yeah, but I'm not a writer. And you know what? I get it. I used to feel the same way. But what I found was over time, the more that I started to write, the more addicting that it actually became. It's actually therapeutic. And like anything else, the more you do it, the better you get. You know, it's funny. I go back and I read some of the stuff I was first posting on Facebook 4 or 5 years ago, and it was terrible. Like, it was terrible. And I'm not the best at punctuation. Like, I have to have Summer read everything before it goes out. Because when I do it, you know, like sometimes when I pause, I just automatically put a comment in there. I don't even follow the grammatical rules. I just think, hey, if I were saying it and I would pause right now, I put a comment in there. But who cares? You know what? Just start writing. Start expressing yourself. And you'll start to fall in love with the process. So how do you come up with content? Everybody always asks, well, you know, how do you come up with the ideas that you write about? First of all, the number one way is to read, read, and read. When I read, I always come up with new ideas for a new blog post. Reading, it's the spark that ignites the new ideas in our life. You know, you've heard the term that readers are leaders, and it's so true. You know, read biographies of successful people, and if you have ADD and you kind of struggle to pay attention, I do, then just read blogs or articles. Subscribe to your favorite blogs and the RSS newsfeed so that you don't even have to go out and seek those articles. When they post, they just automatically come directly to you. But reading, it allows you to, it takes your mind into places that you might not be, and it gets the creative juices flowing. The second way is to pay attention to what's happening around you. There's lessons in everything. I mean, everything. So share your learning experiences with others. Another one of my favorites is be vulnerable, right? Share the good and the bad. Don't just, you know, talk about all the good things that are happening. Vulnerability is the bridge that builds true relationships, and it's how we truly relate and we connect with others. So share these learning lessons. You know, I go about my day, and if I see something, I'll take note of it. And that leads to my next point. When I get an idea or there's a lesson, write it down. right? Get a success journal or keep a journal specifically for this. You never know when a great idea will hit you. How many times have you come up with a great idea and you said, ah, you know what, I'm gonna remember that one for later, and you forget it? I mean, I've done this so many times. If it's worth remembering, it's definitely worth writing down, right? The next thing, and this is very important, especially when it comes to blog posts, is you need to learn how to nail your headline, right? When content's shared on Twitter or Facebook or LinkedIn and even other platforms, there's a huge opportunity for it to get discovered by others. So how can you increase the likelihood that somebody's gonna click to your content when a shared link flows down a person's social stream? Well, what makes you click on a particular link that you share on social media? Chances are it's a great headline that catches your attention and it earns your click, right? Along with a good photograph. That means that no matter what the subject, a great headline will help that piece of content spread much further. So what makes a great headline? It's similar to writing a great subject line for email marketing, for those of you that have lists. Same concept. How do you get somebody's attention in an email so that they click on your email and open it? Think about the four U's for great subject lines and headlines. Number one, useful. Why is this blog post valuable, right? Number two, ultra specific. What can I expect to learn from this blog post? Number three, unique. Why is this blog post compelling and unique? And then add a little bit of urgency, right? That's the last one. Why should I read this right now? Be sure to incorporate all four of these qualities in every headline that you write, and people will be more prone to continue sharing your content across social media. I'm gonna give you another bonus one here real quickly. Go join some type of a Shutterstock, deposit photos, some type of get a membership where you can pay monthly. It's not gonna cost you a lot of money, so that you can have access to high quality photos. You know, it's amazing to me how many photos are reshared out there on social media with somebody else's brand, somebody else's, you know, logos. You know, the quality it's been shared so many times that it's distorted and it doesn't look good. Go get some quality pictures. Just that alone, when you post, will set you apart from everybody else. The next thing is you need to learn how to find your voice, right? You need to write in your own unique voice. Don't try to copy somebody else. Your content should have an individual style that is unique to your personality or your brand. And once you develop your own voice, you're not done. Writers never stop working on their writing skills. You know, as a content writer, you need to continually hone your skills too. Style is your most prized possession as a writer, and it should continue to evolve over the lifetime of your career. You know, there's a great quote by Ernest Hemingway. He says, "We are all apprentices in a craft where no one ever becomes a master." If you haven't found your voice yet, just keep practicing. It's gonna come. And typically, creative professionals, they go through three stages of development. They go through imitation first, imitation mastery is second, and finally, innovation. And you start out reading and studying the styles of the writers that you admire, and then you use what you learn to develop your own style. Just remember, the great content, it builds relationships. And relationships are built on trust. And trust is what drives revenue, right? That's the goal. Now, as we start to wrap things up here today, I promised you that I would share with you one thing that will absolutely ignite your business, take your business to the next level. And that one thing is coaching, or excuse me, is serving your way to the top. And then we're gonna get into business coaching for a moment. You know, I used to work on a coaching floor. And when I was on that coaching floor, we were marketing products that helped business owners go from where they are to where it is that they want to go. And we would address the biggest barriers to success. And this was a long time ago. And in the process of working on this floor, I learned a valuable skill that has helped me to have the success that we've had in business today. And that is, I learned the concept of serving versus selling. So many people get confused. So many people, I want you to think about this. When somebody tries to sell you something, what happens? right? You naturally resist. Nobody likes to be closed. Everybody wants to buy, but nobody wants to be closed. And so many of you, I want you to really hear me. Many of you are out there selling and telling and trying to convince people to buy your service and buy your products. And when you do that, you lose posture. People, you're not valuing what it is that you truly bring to the table, which is you and your ability to be able to help other people. And so what I learned through this process was how to stop selling and create an environment where people started to let their guards down because it was more about them. And that's the first thing I want you to understand. It is not about you, okay? It's about the person on the other side of the table. That's what your presentation is really about. You know, so many people are so anxious to sit down and they'll ask 1 to 2 qualifying questions. How you been? What have you been up to lately? And then they want to go right into their pitch, right? You've got to resist the itch to pitch. Because when you do that, people are going to resist. Why? Because it's just common nature. We are designed to be skeptics. We resist. Even if something we want, if somebody's trying to sell it, just like going to a gym, right? You go to a gym and you sit down with a sales guy and they're pushing and pushing. You might want to get in shape, but just the mere fact that somebody's trying to close you puts you into a position where you are now resisting, right? It's not about you. It's about the person on the other side of the table, about their goals, about what it is that they want, where they're dissatisfied. So you have to understand that. It's not about your product. I know that some of you have some great products at your company that you offer or within your respective businesses, but it's not even about that. It's the solution that your product will provide, right? Again, it's about the person on the other side of the table. So you have to understand what your presentation is about first if you really want to make that transition from selling to serving. You know, selling is a great skill. I don't have anything against salespeople. I think, you know, selling is an art form. And I think selling will take you very far in life. But I think that there's something that happens when you shift your mindset from selling to serving, from a leadership level that takes you to the next level, that allows you to become that legacy leader where you're now developing other leaders, right? And so again, it's about the person that you're talking to. And the way that you do this, the way that you shift from presenting is by asking questions, right? When I'm just going over information and I'm sharing about my company, about my products, about my opportunity, about the owners of the company, when the company started, blah, 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 blah. All I'm doing is I'm putting information out. You're selling, you're telling. But when you ask questions, you're listening. There's a big difference, right? You gotta learn to ask the right questions. You know, when I get on a phone call with somebody, I open every single call the exact same way. Some of you might have been on a phone call with me. You know exactly how I started. Hey, listen, I'm excited to be here with you today. My name's Travis. It's nice to meet you. Before we get started, and we can talk business down the road, tell me a little bit about you. Anything that you're comfortable sharing, you're sharing, your story. I just love to get to know people, and then I can do the same. We can get to know each other a little bit better. It's very common for me to have a 30-minute conversation before we even get into business. What does that do? It develops rapport, and it shows the person on the other side of the table that I genuinely care about them. And usually that conversation just leads me down a natural path. Tell me a little bit about what you do for a living. What is it that you like the best about what you do? What is it that you like least about what you do? Most people have something that's they don't like so much about their job. You know, if you had your ideal situation, what would that look like? How does that differ from what you're doing today? You know, these questions allow me to gather information and ultimately decide if I can truly help that person, if I can help them in an area where they're dissatisfied, or I can help them go from where it is that they want to go. I might have somebody say, well, you know, I'd love to be able to have a little bit more stability in life. You know, I'm a salesperson and my income relies on that next sale. And it's up and down and up and down and up and down. And my ideal situation would be to have a little bit more stability in life. Okay, great. So if I could show you a way to have a little bit more stability in your life and allow you to be able to have a little bit more peace of mind, is that something that you would be open to taking a look at? See, it's not about my presentation. It's about giving them that stability. It's about them. And that's what you have to learn. It's all about asking the right questions. It's all about listening. You've got to learn to stop talking. God gave you 2 ears and 1 mouth for a reason. So you've got to understand. And we have a course, an Entrepreneur Life, that's outstanding. Serving Your Way to the Top, fantastic course that teaches you all about how to do this. But this is probably one of the most important and critical things that people, they get the concept, but they struggle with. They struggle with, and this is where we spend a lot of time with our coaching clients. The next thing is you gotta be a professional problem solver. That's what you're doing. At the end of the day, you are solving problems. You have to get to someone's source of pain and understand. Everybody has one. I'm telling you, if you have somebody who makes a lot of money, they might not have a lot of time. They might not have great health. You know, I'm telling you that everybody has a source of pain. You just have to become a master at showing that you care, because when you show people that you care, they're going to open themselves up to you. And you do that by asking the right questions. And when you do that, what happens is you build value. You know, I have people come to me all the time saying, well, people, I just can't get people to look at my presentation. They say that they're not interested in businesses like this. They don't have time. If you're getting those type of objections, I want you to listen to me. That means you're not building enough value. You're not. You're not building enough value in what it is that you are bringing to the table. If you're making it about your opportunity, chances are you're getting those objections all the time. Because as you start to really get to know someone and understand that this person is in a position where they want to retire their spouse because they believe that that spouse should be in a position to be able to spend more time with their grandparents or their grandchildren at this age and not necessarily have to be working all the time, and that's their driving force. And you start to speak to that and start talking about helping them to retire their spouse, you're building the value. And they're going to connect the dots and say, yeah, I'll take a look at what it is that you're working on, because they now have connected the dots to retiring that spouse or creating a retirement plan for themselves because that's quickly approaching, or creating enough income for that kid that's going to college, or getting out of that miserable, blood-sucking job that they hate, whatever it is. But you have to figure out how to attach to that. That's how you build value. And when the value is there, people will follow through. So again, serving your way to the top, one of the most important things that you can do. All right, now let's get into it. I jumped ahead a little bit earlier. So what's the number one way that you can explode your business? I'm just gonna tell you that the breakthroughs that I've had, I'm talking about big, major breakthroughs where I've pushed through the ceiling, gone from, you know, this income to this income to this income up here, was with coaching. It's with coaching. Think about it. Michael Jordan, one of the best basketball players of all time. Did he have a coach? Of course he did. Somebody that was there every day to push him, to provide feedback, to provide accountability, right? That's what coaches do. And somewhere along the way of life, we tend to, you know, start to just settle, and it's easier to not have a coach. Why? Because then we don't have to be accountable to ourselves. But that is the very reason why 80%+ of small businesses fail. Coaching is what changes everything. It's where business breakthroughs happen. Accountability is so essential for you, for me, for all of us. If we want to go to the next level, it is essential. Coaches provide feedback. They give you new ideas. They allow you to stand on the shoulders of giants, people that have been there before you. You know, it allows you to avoid the pitfalls and the trial and errors that most people go through in life. What's that worth to you? If you could shave off a couple, 2-3 years of learning curves, right? What's that worth to you? If you could get to that goal, that big goal that you have, so much faster, what is that worth to you? It's everything. It's everything. Coaching allows you to accomplish goals more quickly. It allows you to be able to make more money in your career, your profession, in your business. It is an absolute investment in you. At the end of the day, I don't care what company, what business that you are in, you're selling you. It's all about you. It's about the value that you bring to the table. And as you start to raise your leadership level, let's say on a scale of 1 to 10, you know, let's just pick a number. Let's say it's a 4. That's where you're at right now, 4. And I'm not saying you personally. I'm just saying hypothetically speaking. If you start to raise that to a 5 and a 6 and a 7, you start to attract better people in your life. You start to attract bigger opportunities into your life. you start to see things differently. You start to raise the lid on what you believe is possible, the expectations that you have for yourself. You know, I have huge expectations. You know, if I shared my goals with friends that don't play at that same level, they might think that I'm crazy. In fact, I have family members that think that I'm unrealistic. Great, because I want to be unrealistic. Because that expectation is what's allowed me to be able to have the success that I want to have. And so it's so critical that you align yourself with somebody who has that big vision, who has accomplished what it is that you want in life. And that's so important. You know, on social media today, everybody's marketing something. I see this all the time, right? And I see posts about it. Everybody's a teacher or a coach today. You know what? Number one, I think that there's a big need for coaches. But let's be clear. People who have accomplished the kind of success that you want to have. A lot of people want to just take that shortcut and go right into coaching without ever doing. So if you're looking for a coach or if you're aligning with someone, find someone who has had the kind of success that you want to have in life. And more importantly, they have the kind of values that you want to have, right? Do they have a happy marriage? Someone can be successful in business, but you know, they don't have a happy marriage. They're never at home with their family. So ask yourself, what are my values? What's important to me? And does this person have the kind of success that I want to have in life? But at the end of the day, you guys, coaching is what's going to allow you to go from here to here and do it so much faster. What is that worth to you? Now, we've put together a very special promotion that I want to share with you today. And this offer is, it's going to be good literally for 24 hours. That's it. So from the time that this webinar ends tonight through tomorrow, this special promotion will be up. And we did this because we wanted to create a coaching program that would help small business owners literally ignite their business and really create that momentum going into 2017. So we created a 5-week coaching program. It's a virtual coaching program, which means that you get to log into our university. You can access these courses on demand. Each new course will open up every Monday for you. You log in, you literally take the courses. When you're done, you take a quiz, you get certified. But the information in these courses is essential. It's, in fact, if someone came to me today and said, Travis, I want you to coach me to be successful in business, this is where we would start. And these are the first 5 sessions that you and I would do together. So I've taken these courses, I actually wrote curriculum, we filmed them in studio, some of the highest engaging quality content that's available online from a coaching standpoint. Let me go through what these are. The first one is a course that I love. It's called Cultivating the Mindset of an Entrepreneur, right? If you don't have your mind right, you don't have anything. You've got to get your head right. And so we put a course together. It's an over an hour long that teaches you about mindset and the strategies that top producers use to get their head right, their belief systems, their values, those type of things, so that you've got your thinking right, right? Your thinking is everything. You've got to think your way to success. We said it earlier. It's a $197 course, and we are offering it at a significant discount today, but not just that course. We've also put together another course that I absolutely love. It's called Facing Your Giants. Most people are living their fears, right? They're not living their dreams. But how do you really move past those fears? Fear of failure, fear of rejection, fear of even success, right? Those are all fear of what people think of me. We give you a bulletproof strategy of how to move past those fears so that you can start living the entrepreneur life that you deserve. Another course that's in this particular coaching program is Connecting to Thrive in Business. You know, I put this course together because, you know, I asked myself, what's one of the most important skills that you've learned that has allowed you and Summer to be successful in business? And really, it's building relationships, right? It's connecting at the heart level and learning how to nurture those relationships. It's all about connecting to thrive in business. So we put a course together that teaches you how to grow your network on purpose, to develop relationships. What is it at the core level that allows you to build relationships of trust and ultimately be able to expand that network? Somebody once said that you can never have enough relationships. They're like money in the bank, right? You can never have enough of them. So we're going to teach you how to go out to connect to thrive in business. Course number 4 is so critical. It's all about branding, right? People are so confused about branding today. They think that marketing and branding are one and the same, and they're not. They're two totally different things. It's like the sun and the moon. And branding has changed so much, again, with social media. So what we've done is we have taken the principles that we've used to build million-dollar businesses online, and we're sharing those secrets in this course. It's called Unlocking the Secrets of Building a Million-Dollar Brand. Summer and I have been very, very specific about how we've built our brand online. That's allowed us to sponsor hundreds of people online and build to the number one position inside of three different companies. We built our businesses primarily online. So we're gonna teach you exactly how we did that. The most effective strategies to build a brand, both online and offline, and on a shoestring budget as well. And finally, this course is so critical today. It's called The New Era of Marketing. And this course is going to teach you the most effective marketing strategies today from a return on investment standpoint. And more importantly, how to go out and market your business and get the kind of results that you're looking for that lead to an increase in sales. So again, we've put together this Ignite program, this coaching program. The value on this program is almost $1,000, and tonight we're offering it to you for $274. In fact, you can sign up right here and right below me. There's an add to cart button. If you click on that cart, you'll be able to take advantage of this offer. Again, 24 hours. Clock starts right now. You can take advantage of this special offer. What you can expect is from the time that you sign up, you'll get an email from my team that tells you how to log into the university. You'll get access immediately to our first coaching session, and you and I will be spending 5 weeks together here where we're going to be going through and teaching you these principles of how to be successful in business. So with that, once again, I want to say thank you to those of you that are plugging in to the Entrepreneur Life, you know, this community that we are building. Make sure that you're part of our Entrepreneur Life community. We have an outstanding affiliate program for those of you that are looking to create more leads in your business and create an additional revenue stream without having a conflicting business. Maybe you're in network marketing and you don't want to build conflicting businesses. This is the perfect complementary business for you. We definitely encourage you to go over to myelifepro.com and check out the benefits of becoming an affiliate. And lastly, stay plugged into what we're doing. We've got some great information we're going to continually be releasing, excellent trainings that we're releasing each week into the new free coaching library. And I'll tell you, we've got some outstanding coaching programs that are available. So we definitely encourage you to plug in, take advantage of this outstanding eIgnite program that we've put together for you. And with that, thank you guys so much for tuning in. We'll look forward to connecting with you again soon. Take care.